So this is lecture number 2 and the chapter is matter in our surrounding. Matter in our surrounding. So in this part we will continue our discussion and we will see the third property of particles of matter. The third property of particles of matter. And the third property says that particles of matter attract each other. So what does it means? Suppose here is the particle and here is another particle, here is another particle, here is another particle, and here is your another particle. So this particle attracts this, and this also this particle attracts this, this particle attracts this particle, this particle attracts this, this particle also attracts this, this particle attracts this, and this particle also attracts this particle. So in this property says that each and every particles of the matter attracts each other. Clear? Then the next property, particles of matter have some space between them. See, suppose this is a matter, and as this is a matter, it is made of particles. So these are some particles which are present in the matter, and as you can see that there is a huge gap between, there is a huge gap between these particles. And in our previous video we have also seen that in case of water and salt mixture, water and the salt mixture, in that we have seen that water is made of water particle. So let us assume that this is a water particle, this is also another water particle, and this is also another particle of water. And we can see that these water particles have a huge gap between them. This gap is known as intermolecular space. This gap is known as your intermolecular space. Clear? So these are the basics properties of particles of matter. Clear? So on the basis of these properties, on the basis of these properties, matter has been classified into solid, liquid and gas. So let us start our discussion starting from the solid. Let us begin our discussion starting from solid. As you can see that solids have definite shape. Each and every solids have definite shape, and solid can have definite volume. And you can see also that suppose this is a piece of iron I have, and as this is a matter, and as you know that matter is made up of very small tiny particles, and in case of solids, particles are present very, very, very close to each other. So from the above you can conclude that particles have very strong force of attraction, and also particles have no intermolecular space. There is no intermolecular space. Clear? So these are some basic properties of solid state of matter. And also solids are rigid in nature. Rigid. So rigid means what? Rigidity means solids can have the tendency to maintain its shape. Rigidity means the tendency to maintain its shape. So solid substances can have the tendency to maintain its shape. Clear? So in our next video, we will see the properties of liquid, the properties of liquid state of matter. Till then, have a happy learning.